Okay, so the content that we will be completing today or covering in this particular lecture is disaster management plans and need of those disaster management plans, then plans at various levels, preparation of the plans, responsibility of the government and role of various stakeholders in disaster management. Okay, then Sendai framework. Abhi, what is this Sendai framework? Okay, this is an international framework. As you know, international, the various countries globally come together and work towards this management of disaster, correct? Because it is a global crisis, no? It is not just related to particular country, it is a global crisis, okay? So the third UN World Conference in Sendai, that is Japan, Sendai area in Japan, on March 18, 2015, is the successor instrument to the HIGO framework. Successor instrument matlab, before the Sendai framework there was this HIGO framework, okay, that is also a blueprint, an international agreement only for action to be taken to reduce this disaster for one particular decade, that is 2005 to 2015. For this particular decade this HIGO framework was made. Following this HIGO framework, it is written a successor instrument to HIGO framework, that is following this HIGO framework, when this HIGO framework was made, okay, immediately this Sendai framework was also made in the year 2015 itself. This Sendai framework is actually like a roadmap of how to deal with the disaster risk. Okay, so immediately following this HIGO framework, this Sendai framework was made in 2015 till the time period of 2015 to 2030. For that time period this Sendai framework was made. It is a non-binding agreement. It is not compulsion for all the nations to be a part of it. It is on the voluntary basis. Whoever wants to be can be. It is a non-binding agreement which the signatory nations including India will attempt to comply with on a voluntary basis. The four priorities for action under the Sendai framework are understanding the disaster risk, strengthening the disaster risk governance to manage disaster risk, investing in disaster risk reduction for resilience to deal with it, make the country more resilient, enhancing disaster preparedness for effective response and to build back better in recovery, rehabilitation and reconstruction. So these are the four priorities for action under Sendai framework, and our country is also part of this particular Sendai framework. Okay, so it is a roadmap actually which deals with how to deal with the disaster risk. Before managing disaster management, what you say is after when the disaster occurs, the management of the disaster. But at this first stage only, dealing with the disaster risk. Okay, so that comes under this Sendai framework. Then disaster risk reduction and management. So you know what is disaster. We have seen this definition from the first lecture itself. The United Nations International Strategy on Disaster Reduction, UNISDR 2009, defines disaster as a serious disruption of the functioning of a community or a society involving widespread human, material, economic or environmental losses and impacts which exceeds the ability of the affected community or society to cope using its own resources. Similar definitions we have seen, correct? So, but these words or these lines are actually the definitions given by United Nations International Strategy for Disaster Reduction. Then, disaster management. So, the organization, planning and application of measures, preparing, responding to and initial recovery from the disaster. So, that is the definition given for disaster management. Few of the pictures of disaster management. Basically, it is the response, the first stage, response and relief. Then, what is the vision? So, making India disaster resilient. Disaster resilient in the sense, coping up with the disaster, coping up with the affected community, you know, the affected community, recovering them as possible, as early as possible. So that is making India disaster resilient. Dealing with the disaster and coming up again, recovering from all the difficulties, that is called disaster resilient. So vision is that make India disaster resilient, achieve substantial disaster risk reduction, and significantly decrease the losses of life, livelihood, and the important things, that is assets. The assets could be economical, physical, social, cultural, and environmental. By maximizing the ability to cope with the disaster at all levels of administration as well as among the communities. Then, objectives. So, what are the objectives in order to complete this vision? What do we call as vision? It is a future perspective. In future, this is my target or this is my aim. So in few years, coming years, I have to achieve this vision for my country, correct? And to achieve this vision, what will be the objectives? Improve the understanding of disaster risk, hazards, and vulnerability, correct? Unless and until people have knowledge, understanding of what is disaster risk, hazard, and vulnerabilities, the next step could not be taken. So that is the first thing, improve the understanding. Strengthen the disaster risk governance, that is management, at all the levels from local to center. Then invest in disaster risk reduction for resilience. Resilience again is what is coming, that is to cope with the disaster and to recover as early as possible. Okay, so invest in the disaster risk reduction for resilience through structural, non-structural, and financial measures, as well as comprehensive capacity development. I have already told you what do you mean by capacity development. Is development training of people. Okay, then enhance disaster preparedness for effective response. If you are well prepared to deal with a disaster, effective response is of course going to happen after a disaster occurs. Then promote build back better in recovery, rehabilitation, and reconstruction. Recovering in a better way, coming back again in a better way, preparing yourself in a better way. Then prevent disasters and achieve substantial reduction of disaster risk and losses in lives, livelihoods, health, and assets, that is economical, physical, social, cultural, or environmental. Then increase the resilience and prevent the emergence of the new disaster risk and reducing the existing risk. Then what are the more objectives? Promote implementation of integrated and inclusive economic, structural, legal, social, health, cultural, educational, environmental, technological, political, and institutional measures to prevent and reduce the hazard exposure and vulnerabilities to disaster. Empower both local authorities and communities as partners to reduce and manage the disaster risk. As we were talking about the Sendai framework, right, which deals with the disaster risk. So we are talking about the objectives of it. Strengthen scientific and technical capabilities in all aspects of disaster management. Then capacity development at all the levels to effectively respond to multiple hazards and for community-based disaster management. Provide clarity on roles and responsibilities of various ministries and departments involved in different aspects of disaster management. That is important. You have to know the institutional framework and you have to know the responsibility of each of the organization, each of the ministry, each of the department. Promote culture of disaster risk prevention and mitigation at all the level. Facilitate the mainstreaming of disaster management concerns into developmental planning and processes. So, as you know, we have seen this slide so many times. What is disaster management? Which is the combination of preparedness, response, recovery, and mitigation. correct? You have written it in the test as well. Okay, so preparedness is activities that are prior to a disaster, and examples are preparedness plans, emergency exercises, training, warning systems. The response is nothing but activities during a disaster, that is public warning systems, emergency operations, search and rescue. Then recovery, that is activities following a disaster, which could be temporary housing, claims, processing and grants, long-term medical care and counseling. And mitigation is activities that reduce the effect of the disaster, that is building codes and zoning, vulnerability analysis and public education. So all this combine the disaster management process. Now, what does disaster management involve? It deals with and avoiding both the natural and man-made disaster, correct? Preparedness before the disaster and rebuilding and supporting the society after this natural or man-made disasters, right? Then, principles of planning. When a disaster management plan is to be made, okay? Of course, every nation has its own disaster management plan, correct? So what are the things that should be considered while making this disaster management plan? That is called the principles of planning. So when developing a disaster management plan, observance of the planning principles mentioned below. These principles are to be taken into account while making the disaster management plan. That is simplicity. The plan should be simple, concise, very specific, simple to understand. Roles and responsibilities should be clearly stated, easily understandable, and written in very simple way. Roles and responsibilities shall be clearly stated. Then flexibility, the plan shall be flexible, applicable. Okay, flexible, it should be applicable to all the areas and it should be feasible, possible. Comprehensive, it shall describe arrangements for preventing, preparing for, responding to and recovering from the effects of the emergency. Then decision making process. The plan shall describe the decision making process which will be adopted when an emergency occurs. While each emergency will be different, the decision making process will remain reasonably consistent. Okay, so the way the decision making process should happen, right, from the apex agency to the lower agency, how the contact has to be done, how the awareness has to be done, how to be communication to be done, how to involve the public, everything, the whole decision making process has to be mentioned, I mean taken into account while making the disaster management plan. Consultation. One shall see to it that the plan suits and is understood by everyone. Okay, the commitment of individuals to the plan is likely to be greatest when they have been involved in its development. Okay, so next is dissemination. All the members of the community shall be familiar with the content of the plan and shall be trained and regularly exercise its procedures. Okay, so all those people, all those organizations, all those agencies which are part of this plan, that we will call it as the members of the community, correct? They should be familiar with the whole content of the plan and they should be regularly trained, okay, for this particular action plan. Then review. The plan needs to be reviewed on a regular basis, of course. The disaster management plan has to be reviewed because the frequency of the disaster, the way the disasters are happening, the way the scope of the disasters has increased, it is way different every year, correct? So the plan needs to be reviewed on a regular basis, preferably annually and following any significant emergency to ensure that it remains workable. It's not like that the plan was made before 10-15 years and it's not reviewed or modified because the condition is not same at this particular year, correct? And therefore it has to be regularly reviewed, regularly improved so that it remains workable, so that it can be used every time when needed. Then coordination. planning should be coordinated with other agencies. While this planning is done, okay, it has to be communicated, it has to be coordinated with other agencies such as emergency services and local municipalities, who shall have their own plans linked with the plans of the districts, municipalities or the surrounding community. This is very important. When you have a national disaster management plan, it should be coordinated with the other lower agencies as well, so that it maps with the, it is in line with the state disaster management plan, it is in line with the district disaster management plan, it is in line with the local disaster management plan. Okay, so that way the coordination has to be done, and it could be done while communicating with the other agencies, while taking the participation of the other agencies. Then policy issues shall be resolved during the planning process. Consistency. The plan should be consistent with the local policies of relevant education authorities. Scope of responsibilities. The plan shall describe the scope and limitations and responsibilities, of course. Cooperation. The plan shall also emphasize the role in providing support to the emergency services, that is police, fire services, ambulance, okay, that are legally responsible for managing the emergency. They are the first respondents actually whenever the disaster occurs. Okay, so the plan should also emphasize on the role of these emergency services people. Then, as we know, just see that what are the principles or things that should be taken into account while making this disaster management plan. But why do you need this disaster management plan? What is the need of this disaster management plans? So disaster management, or what you can say is disaster preparedness plan, plays a vital role. The officials have complete set of instructions. Okay, that is very important. Whenever you do any work, you do a planning of it. Why do we do a planning of it? So that at the immediate point when some complication occurs, you have a plan ready to be followed, the instructions ready to be followed. Correct? So the officials have the complete set of instructions due to the disaster management plan, which they can follow to do, and also issue directions to their subordinates and the affected people. This has effect of not only speeding up the rescue and relief operation, but also boosting the morale of the affected people. When people have confidence that the agencies are actually working towards disaster management in a proper planning, in a proper management, okay, so it boosts the effect, the morale of the affected people as well. And when you have a plan, when you have set of instructions, when you have a strategy to be followed, already noted down, and you just have to follow it step by step, correct? So it will speed up the rescue and relief operations. The disaster management plan are also useful at pre-disaster stage, where warnings could be issued. Correct? This disaster management plan actually deals with all pre-disaster, during disaster and post-disaster stages. Okay, so it is very useful during the pre-disaster stage as well, when warnings are needed to be issued. Plan again serves as guide to officials at the critical time, and precious time is saved which might otherwise be lost in consultation with the senior officers and getting formal approval from the authorities. Correct? When you have a plan already made, you have set of instructions, it is a guide for everyone who is involved in the disaster management process. So it speeds up the process, correct? And whatever the critical time or the precious time that will be lost otherwise in discussions, in taking the permission of the officials, that could be reduced. Then, neither economical nor practicable to protect every item and the entire population against a calamitous situation, these response plans are actually formulated for relief, rehabilitation and restoration by separate agencies. Correct? Then, this is a particular, a flow chart where you have development, disaster management plan, prevention, mitigation and preparedness. Correct? These are prior to any disaster that occurs, and after the disaster occurs, you have this response, relief and recovery operations. Just a second. Okay? Then, the plan has basically two components, majorly. Basically, it is pre-disaster and the post-disaster, we will call as. Okay, there is the plan components, hazard identification and safety assessment, that is structure assessment, non-structure assessment and resource inventory. Before identifying, when before that disaster occurs. So hazard identification, and under which you have structure assessment, non-structure assessment and resource inventory. That is the preparation what you have. Then response plan. That is mitigation of the hazards identified, evacuation plan and special provisions for handicapped people. Okay, so basically it has this two components. Then characteristics of disaster. Basically the characteristics of disaster, when you want to understand any disaster, so you will understand based on this particular points. Predictability, is that disaster predictable? Controllability, is that particular disaster easily controllable? Duration of the impact, for how much time period the disaster is going to occur? Speed of the onset, how fast the disaster is going to occur? Scope and intensity of the impact, how intense and how much area or how much people will be affected? Length of the forewarning, the warning system, from how much time this warning has to be given, how much how this warning has to be spread. Okay, that are all these characteristics of disaster. So if you want to understand any disaster, you need to understand based on this particular points. Then levels of disasters. The disaster management and its planning at various tiers, that is the stages, must take into account the vulnerability of disaster affected area and the capacity of the authorities to deal with the situation. Correct. Whenever the planning has to be done at any stage, okay, at any stage of the disaster management cycle, maybe the preparedness, mitigation, response, recovery, rehabilitation, reconstruction, anything. At any stage, when this disaster management and planning has to be done, we must take into account how vulnerable that particular area is to that particular disaster, and how the authorities of that area could deal with the disaster. That is the capacity of the authorities to deal with the situation. And accordingly, the plan at every stage for a particular area has to be made. Using this approach, the High Power Committee on Disaster Management, in its report of 2001, categorized the disaster situation into three levels, L1, L2 and L3, and the period of normalcy, there is no disaster period, L0, should be utilized for disaster risk reduction. Okay, L0 is nothing but the period of normalcy when there is no disaster. So when there is no disaster happening in the area, that time period has to be used for disaster risk reduction strategies. Okay, planning of those disaster risk reduction measures. So what is L1, L2 and L3? So level L1 means the level of disaster that can be managed within the capabilities and resources at the district level. That means the scope of the disaster is not that high. Okay, it could be managed within the capabilities and resources at the district level. However, the state authorities will remain in readiness to provide the assistance if needed. It's not like that it's the work of only district level and the other authority, higher authorities, will not be a part of it. They have to be well prepared in case any help needed. But since it comes in the L1, that is the level of the disaster, that could be managed at the district level. Then level L2. So this signifies that the disaster situations that require assistance and active mobilization of the resources at the state level and deployment of the state level agencies for disaster management. The central agencies must remain vigilant for immediate deployment if required by the state. The higher to L1 is L2. When the scope of the disaster increases and it has to be managed at the state level. Okay, so that is L2, and of course the central agencies have to remain vigilant for if immediate any help require, any assistance require. Then L3, this corresponds to nearly catastrophic situation, a very dangerous situation affecting lot of people, affecting the environment to an extent, okay, or a very large scale disaster. Basically catastrophic situation is that overwhelms the state and district authorities, that is it requires the help from all the at the state, at the district, at the national, I mean the central level, everyone has to respond to it. The categorization of the disaster situation into levels of L0 to L3 finds no mention in Disaster Management Act 2005. However, Disaster Management Act does not have any provision for notifying any disaster as national calamity or a national disaster. That is, even if this categorization is not mentioned in Disaster Management Act. Okay, see, this was made by some high power committee on disaster management in its one of the report. This is not the part, that is that this levels and all you won't see it in the Disaster Management Act. Okay, but in that act you won't notice everywhere the disaster is specified as a national disaster. It is also divided into the roles by district, state and the national level depending upon the intensity of the disaster. Now, National Disaster Management Authority, the top body to deal with the disaster. So this is the framework under National Disaster Management Authority, that is the agencies, the ministries involved under this National Disaster Management Authority. So you have the chairman first, then the vice chairman, and then you have four members. Okay, now these four members, out of which there are Advisor Policy and Plan, Advisor Operations, Advisor Mitigation, Joint Secretary Administration, Financial Advisor, Project NCRMP. Okay, so all these are the names, I mean the institutional framework, the name of the agencies that you should just, you should know that how the hierarchy is. Okay, then you have Joint Advisor Policy and Plan, Joint Advisor PR and AG, Joint Advisor Operations. Okay, then you have Joint Advisor Communications and IT, then Joint Advisor Mitigation Projects, Joint Advisor Mitigation Project and Procurement, the Deputy Secretary Administration, Joint Advisor CBT. Now what is CBT? Capacity Building and Training. Okay, and this NCRMP is National Cyclone Risk Mitigation Plan for particular cyclone disaster. Okay, you have this particular agency. Okay, so likewise you have Director Finance, Deputy Project Director. Same way, if you could see, there are a lot more of agencies that are dealing, I mean that come under this framework, and those every one of them together makes this National Disaster Management Authority. Okay, so chairman, vice chairman, that you are, and then there are members, okay, and then under them the members are nothing but the advisor policy and plan, advisor of the policy and plan, advisor of the operations, advisor of mitigation, joint secretary of administration, financial advisor, project director of NCRMP. Okay, these are the people involved when you talk about members. So who are they? They are these people. Okay, and under which you again have joint advisors, okay, deputy secretary. See, under advisors you have joint advisors, under secretary, joint secretary, you have deputy secretaries, okay, then you have directors, under project director you have deputy project director, okay. Then again, if you see under joint advisor, you have assistant advisors, okay, and then under deputy project director you have project manager, okay. So this framework you need to remember, okay, that who all comprises of the National Disaster Management Authority. Then disaster management plans at various levels, as we know, we have just seen that at every level this disaster management plan has to be made. Contingency action plan. So what do you mean by contingency? Any event which is going to occur in future, okay, any further event, okay, so that is called the contingency action plan, which is nothing but it becomes the part of preparedness, preparing the community, the nation, for a future event, for a future disaster. So contingency action plan at national level list out detail of the actions to be taken at various levels of government at the time of calamity. Okay, CAP, that is contingency action plan. So the steps that are taken before disaster is identification of vulnerable areas which are more prone, correct, monitoring and setting up the control rooms, warnings, arrangement for relief camps, food, essential commodities, medical facilities, etc. Fund allocation, alerting the administration, community preparedness. So all this comes under steps taken before the disaster in this contingency action plan. Steps taken during the disaster, that is evacuation, setting up of relief camps and handling, monitoring and report, VIP visit, correct. Then steps to be taken after the disaster, that is disposal of the dead bodies, cleaning of the debris, disbursement of the relief, okay, and steps taken for reconstruction, that is closure of the relief camps, restoration of the infrastructure, recognition of the good work and feedback of the whole planning. Then institutional framework. Now we just saw the organization of NDMA. Who are all the agencies, the departments, the ministries who are the part of the National Disaster Management Authority? Okay, now institutional framework of our country, when you say that is from the national level to state, district, local level, how is the hierarchy and who are the people that, or the ministries or the departments that are the part of this framework? Okay, so when we talk about national level, the overall coordination of disaster management vests with the Ministry of Home Affairs. This was a question in your test as well, that who is the apex body. So the apex body, the topmost apex body, okay, who deals with the disaster management, I mean who is the apex body of the disaster management process, okay, so that is the Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA. Okay, then the cabinet committee on security, that is CCS, and National Crisis on Management Committee, NCMC, are the key committees involved in the top level decision making with regard to disaster management. okay, Ministry of Home Affairs is the apex body, and then come the top level decision making committees, that is the Cabinet Committee on Security, CCS, and National Crisis Management Committee, it is NCMC. The NDMA is the lead agency responsible for preparation of the disaster management plan and the execution at the national level. Correct. National Disaster Management Authority is the main agency responsible for preparing the disaster management plan. State government will be carrying out disaster management, with the central government playing a supporting role. Correct. The center agencies will participate only on the request of the state government. Within each state, there is a separate institutional framework for disaster management at the state level. Correct. For national level type of disaster, okay, so you have committees or the departments that are dealing with at the national level, right? From the Ministry of Home Affairs to the CCS to this NCMC, okay, and the NDMA. But anything that could be dealt with within the state, okay, so they have their own framework at the state level, and they have their own plan, of course, which is in line with the national plan, but they have their own plans at the state level as well. So see, if you could see this, that is national level disaster management basic institutional framework. Okay, so here you could see national disaster management institutional mechanism. Okay, so overall coordination, that is Ministry of Home Affairs. Then below this you have designated nodal ministries in relation to particular disaster. Okay, the nodal ministry is disaster specific. Then you have National Disaster Management Authority. Okay, then you have National Executive Committee, NEC. Everything is linked. See here, top level decision making by Cabinet Committee on Security, CCS, and National Crisis Management Committee, NCMC. Okay, and then they are connected to the state government or the union territories. And here NDMA, okay, which then have Armed Force and Central Armed Police Forces, National Institute of Disaster Management, National Disaster Response Force, that also comes under NDMA, which is also part of this institutional mechanism. Okay, this is just a brief idea. This is just a brief idea that you have overall coordination that is done by the Ministry of Home Affairs, under which you have designated nodal ministries which are disaster specific ministries for particular type of disaster, and you have National Disaster Management Authority. Okay, then for top level decision making, you have Cabinet Committee on Security and National Crisis Management Committee, under which you have the state government or the union territories, in case if the decision making is also required at the state level. Then you have National Executive Committee, under which under that, as well as under the NDMA, if you could see, you have Armed Forces and Central Armed Police Forces, National Institute of Disaster Management, and National Disaster Response Force. And all these agencies, okay, they are linked to each other. Okay, so key national level decision making bodies for disaster management. At national level, the decision making is done by these particular bodies, that is Cabinet Committee on Security, that is CCS, National Crisis Management Committee, that is NCMC, National Disaster Management Authority, NDMA, National Executive Committee, National Disaster Response Force, National Institute of Disaster Management. So if you could see, just a second, all these agencies or ministries or the departments that are the part of the institutional mechanism, they completely together help in decision making at national level. And therefore every department is mentioned here, and the role of every department is given. Okay, so So decision making is dependent on at the national level on these particular departments, that is Cabinet Committee on Security, CCS. So who are part of this Cabinet Committee on Security? Prime Minister, Minister of Defense, Minister of Finance, Minister of Home Affairs, and Minister of External Affairs. What do they do? I mean, what are the responsibilities? Evaluation from a national security perspective if an incident has potentially security complications. Oversee all the aspects of preparedness, mitigation, and management of chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear emergencies or disaster with security implications. So everything related to security. Review the risk of the CBRN. Okay, CBRN, that is chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear. So review the risk of CBRN emergencies from time to time, giving directions for measures considered necessary for disaster prevention, mitigation, preparedness, and effective response. Okay, so basically they are more dealing with the security implications, and therefore chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear emergencies or disaster, which mainly has effect on security. Okay, so they are deal, those emergencies are deal under this CCS. The National Crisis Management Committee, NCMC. So who are the members of this? The Cabinet Secretary, who is the chairperson, and secretaries of ministries or the departments and agencies with specific disaster management responsibilities. So what are the roles? Oversee the command, control, and coordination of the disaster response. Give direction to crisis management group as deemed necessary. Give direction for specific action to face crisis situation. Okay, so that are the roles of National Crisis Management Committee. The National Disaster Management Authority, NDMA. Prime Minister is the chairperson of NDMA, and there are members not exceeding 9 nominated by chairperson, that is nominated by Prime Minister. So what are the roles of NDMA? Lay down the policies, plans, and guidelines for disaster management. Coordinate their enforcement and implementation throughout the country. Approve the National Disaster Management Plan and the disaster management plans of the respective ministries and departments of Government of India. Lay down the guidelines for disaster management to be followed by different central ministries, departments, and the state government. So these are the roles and responsibilities of NDMA. Okay, then you have National Executive Committee. So who are the part of this National Executive Committee? Union Home Secretary, who is the chairperson. Secretaries to the Government of India in the ministries or departments of Agriculture, Atomic, Energy, Defense, Drinking Water and Sanitation, Environment, Forest, Climate Change, Finance, that is Expenditure, Health and Family Welfare, Power, Rural Development, Science and Technology, Space Telecommunication, Urban Development, Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation, the Chief and of the Integrated Defense Staff, the Chief of the Staff Committee, the ex officio as members, secretaries in the Ministry of External Affairs, Earth Sciences, Human Resource Development, Mines, Shipping, Road Transport and Highways, and Secretary, NDMA are special invitees to the meetings of NEC. So if you see National Executive Committee, it comprises of course of a chairperson, of course of the secretaries, but if you could see, it has people from all the varied fields, correct? Well, what are the roles and responsibilities of them? To assist the NDMA in the discharge of its function, and therefore you could see below NDMA is nothing but the National Executive Committee. So what are the roles? To assist the NDMA in the discharge of its functions, preparation of the national plan, coordinate and monitor the implementation of the national policy, monitor the implementation of the national plan and the plans prepared by the ministries or the department of the government of India, direct any department or agency of the government to make available to the NDMA and SDMA, that is the State Disaster Management Authority, such men, material, resources as are available with it for the purpose of emergency response, rescue and relief. Ensure compliance of the directions issued by central government. Coordinate the response in the event of any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Direct the relevant ministries or the departments of the government of India, the state government and the SDMAs regarding measures to be taken in response to any specific threatening disaster situation or disaster. Then coordinate with the relevant central ministries or department or agencies which are expected to provide assistance to the affected state as per the standard operating procedures. Coordinate with the armed forces, the Central Armed Police Forces, National Disaster Response Forces and the other uniformed services which comprise the Government of India's response to aid with the state authorities, Then coordinate with the India Meteorological Department, the IMD, and a number of other specialized scientific institutions which constitute key early warning and monitoring agencies. Coordinate with the civil defense volunteers, home guards and fire services through the relevant administrative department of the state government. So if you could see, the National Executive Committee, which has a huge scope of actions to be taken, because the number of ministries, the number of people involved in this NEC are more, correct? The chairperson, the secretaries from various other departments, correct? Then you have National Disaster Response Force, who are nothing but specially trained force headed by Director General, structure like paramilitary forces for rapid deployment. And what are their roles? Provide assistance to the relevant state government or the district administration in the event of an imminent hazard event or in its aftermath. Okay, then you have National Institute of Disaster Management, and it consists of Union Home Minister, Vice Chairman, NDMA members, including secretaries of various nodal ministries and departments of Government of India and state government, and heads of national level scientific research and technical organizations, beside eminent scholars, scientists and practitioners, because it is an institution. Okay, so in the institution you need people with the background of technical knowledge, people with scientific and research knowledge, practitioners, scholars. Okay, so what are the roles of this institution? What does this institution does? Human resource development and capacity building for disaster management within the broad policies and guidelines laid down by NDMA. Correct? Then design, develop and implement training programs. Undertake research. Formulate and implement a comprehensive human resource development plan. Provide assistance in national policy formulation. Assist other research and training institutes, state governments and other organizations for successfully discharging their responsibilities. Develop education materials for dissemination, for spreading, for distributing. Promote awareness generation. Okay, so that is the roles of National Institute of Disaster Management. Correct? So we have just seen an overview of who all are the departments who are under this National Disaster Management Institutional Mechanism. Okay, and under those bodies, okay, who are nothing but at the national level, they are the decision making bodies which form the National Institutional Mechanism, correct, framework. So under these bodies, who are the members of these bodies, that we have seen. and what are the roles of those bodies that we have seen. Correct? Correct? The Nodal Ministry for Management or Mitigation of Different Disaster. So we have seen this particular PPT, if you remember. That is, when you talk about people responsible to that particular disaster or any department responsible to a particular disaster, when you talk about that, so what is that department? So when you say biological disaster, so department related to that biological disaster is Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Chemical and Industrial, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So you should remember this, huh? In case any question comes that which of the department say is responsible, or the nodal ministry, or the department of landslide disaster or avalanche disaster, so immediately you should know which is the department in related to it. Okay, the civil aviation accident, that is Ministry of Civil Aviation. Cyclone and or tornado, Ministry of Earth Sciences. Tsunami, Ministry of Earth Sciences. Drought, hailstorm, cold wave, frost, pest attack, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. For earthquake, you have Ministry of Earth Sciences. Flood, Ministry of Water Resources. Forest fire, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Landslide, Ministry of Mines. Avalanche, Ministry of Defense. Nuclear and Radiological Emergencies, Department of Atomic Energy. Rail accidents, Ministry of Railways. Road accidents, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Urban floods, Ministry of Urban Development. So these are the ministries or the department, okay, for that particular disaster, right? In that, in the institutional mechanism also, whenever we see that people from this department or department dealing with so and so disaster, so immediately you should know which is that department. Okay, so we will end our lecture today here.